afraid just to say a hello.
Hey.
Or to pick up the phone just to say what is up. It's been a long time and I've been thinking. Give you a call to shoot the shit and fill you in, we're reminiscing.
Yeah.
On the dumb things we did when we were only little children. Up in the hills smoking cigarillos, waiting on a vision.
Past few days, I've been waking up earlier than what I used to, and one important thing that I started doing, and it is really helping me, I don't look at my phone or anything digital for the first half an hour after I get up. I have to say it has impacted me a lot. It really brings a change in your life. You definitely should try. I've been drinking black coffee since about 1.5 years, and now every time I go to have a coffee with milk and sugar, I mean, I just don't like the taste. Is it just me, or do you guys also find the same thing? I think what my boy Will Tennyson just said, once you go black, you can never go back, might just be true. Anyways guys, welcome back to another video. Hope you guys are doing absolutely fine. I am in a desperate need of a haircut. But anyways, just gonna take you through my day. And today we're gonna talk about something really interesting. That is carb cycling. Now I got a lot of requests about this on carb cycling and whether you should do it and how to do it if you're doing carb cycling. So I'm gonna talk a little bit about that in this video. Stay tuned. Let's go. Carb cycling. Now I'm going to keep this very simple, explain it in layman language. If you want proper scientific words, scientific backing behind all this, I'm going to put a link in the description. Go ahead to that page, you'll understand it much more in detail. But for basic, in layman terms, carb cycling is nothing but varying the amount of carbs that you have on a particular day, depending on the workout that you have done or what you plan to do. Now let's break down macronutrients that every food product has. Now three major categories of macronutrients are proteins, fats, and your carbs. Your protein intake should be high in whatever you're eating, moderate amount of carbs, and low and minimal amount of fat in every food product. Now don't get me wrong, there are some food products which are high in fat content and are good for your body. You know, some products are olive oil, avocados, which people recommend. These are good sources of fat that your body requires, and all three micronutrients come together and make a proper composition of your muscle mass, which helps you develop your body. Now let's break down every single category of macronutrients that are there. First being fats. Yes, fats have to be minimal, but every human body requires X amount of fats. I'm not saying that eliminate fats completely. Fats are necessary for you to develop your muscles, but good fats and bad fats are different. Like I said earlier, good fats are olive oil, avocados, healthy fats which fall into food categories. These are essential for your body, should be eaten. Another very, very easy source of good fats is your egg yolk, which a lot of people leave out thinking that, you know, it's too much of calories. Guys, this is a good source of fat. I know to an extent you shouldn't overdo a egg yolk because it does have cholesterol, it does increase your calories, but one whole egg is not going to hurt your calorie intake or even your fat intake in a day. Now coming to protein. According to me, protein every day for an individual, 1.5 grams to 2 grams of protein per kg body weight is essential. If you're hitting a high intensity workout, if you're bodybuilding, even if you're just moderately going out for a walk, minimum 1.5 kgs per body weight of protein is required. So if I'm weighing 84 kgs right now, I would require anywhere between 150 grams to 165 grams of protein intake solely in a particular day. Now coming to carbs. Now, since this video is about carb cycling, we are going to break down carbs into two major categories. One is simple carbs and the second is complex carbs. The best example for simple carbs is sugar. Very easy to digest, quick insulin spike in the body, and it's really, really not good because of the refinement it goes through, and sugar is very easily turned into fat in your body. Now, what is carb cycling? It's easy. Carb cycling is increasing or decreasing the total number of carbs you have on a particular day, depending on the exercise you have done or plan to do in the day. Now let's take an example. Today I did an high intensity interval training with a moderate run. Now these exercises fall in your cardiovascular exercise category. Basically, this means that you increase your heart rate and your body uses energy to create and burn calories. Now this type of exercise can be performed by using your stored energy, which is nothing but fats. So technically, that is the reason why trainers and dietitians say that do a lot of cardio exercises when you want to lose weight. Now on the other hand, when you are doing weight training, so that is when you are working a particular muscle or lifting weights, doing squats, biceps, triceps, there is a tear in the muscle that you are training. Now when there's a tear in the muscle needs to be rebuilt so that you can gain size and become stronger. Now when the muscle is rebuilding, it cannot use the stored sources of energy, which is your fats, to rebuild this muscle. You do need to put in some carbs. On these days when you're training heavy, when you're weight training, you increase the number of carbs that you have so that the muscle building processes happen smoothly. So this is technically called carb cycling. So to put it in simple terms, the day you are lifting heavy weights, you increase the amount of carbs, and the day you're doing cardio activities, which gets your heart rate, where you're burning calories, on those days, you decrease the amount of carbs so that your body goes to the fat sources that it has saved and uses that to create energy. So that was a little bit about carb cycling. Like I said, I'm going to put a link in the description below. Check it out for more details. Again, guys, not a dietitian. I don't have any biology background. This is just something that I have done. I have experienced. I'm just sharing my experience with you. Please take advice from a proper dietitian. Yaar, itna baat karke na bahut bhook lagi hai. Let's see what's there for lunch. I'm hungry. Let's go. Just got this funniest thing from Swiggy, and the best part is, look what it says here. We are not responsible for the embarrassment. We do hope that you read it out like the mutual fund guy. There's something about that egg curry that, I mean, it's amazing. I can have it every day for months on months. Follow my Instagram to see the recipe. Let's continue the video.
Have more power than you need. Like to give yourself credit for it. And if you have something that's going on in your life right now that's challenging or painful, it's just a reminder to take a little bit better care of yourself. You're worth it. You can have this feeling.
Today's video here. If you've watched till here, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, share it with your friends, family. Let's grow together. See you guys in the next video. Bye bye. Just loving the vibe of this turtle. Too good.